when I was young, my mom, whenever the Northern Lights came out, she just whistle.
Boy, they come alive. Just keep whistling and that aurora will just like, you know, you can almost hear it.
And then she explained to me a little bit later that those are children, and children who've passed away when they're children. You don't want to draw them in too much, you know, is what she said, because then they could play football with your head, play Eskimo football, and that's what they want to do. They're always playing, those children up there.
Don't play out without your hood on. If you don't have your hood on, the aurora person is going to come down and chop your head off and play ball with your head.
It wasn't like they were trying to do bad, you know, or it was like a scary story or anything like that. It was just, that's how it was, that's what it was.
In the month of November, there's no sun. So during that dark time, we travel by the light of the moon. It's quite different. Everything was silver and black. Toward the horizon, we could see where caribou are because their body heat flowing upward, and we could see it glowing in the moonlight against a dark horizon where there's no stars. If somebody yelled, you couldn't know who yelled from where the sound came from, but when I was growing up, my grandpa had a pet white fox. If you're a good friend with a fox, when there's danger abound, they try to keep you from getting into trouble. They pull tricks here and there, and foxes are like spoiled little kids in a way. When you let her out, she'd go prancing out in the snow, jumping in the air. I know she is happy then. Come running at me and jump on my chest, knock me backwards, lick my face, and I try not to let it. So that was my memory of my grandpa's pet fox.
One of the things I think a lot of people need to understand is we aren't a museum piece. The Inupiaq people are a living people and a living culture. Even though we're in northern Alaska, which covers this vast area from Nome all the way over the Canadian border, is that there is this extreme value of interconnectedness and interdependence.
It's a hunting society, a gathering society from thousands of years.
This is what creates our culture.
That special relationship between humans and the natural world and the animals, and that it teaches you how to have a society that doesn't do too much harm to the world.
Love and respect for nature, for one another, for our elders. Very, very fundamental value, key to life.
Our values are something that bind us all. The importance of sharing with one another, the importance of spirituality, and the connection to the land, our traditions, how we hunt, sharing of stories and songs and dances.
I'm Inupiaq. I'm from the Arctic Ocean.
I am Inupiaq.
It's very important to me. It's who I am as a person.
And we're very proud of who we are, and we want to continue that.
caribou was, it provided for us in many ways.
Our clothing in those days was made of all caribou skin.
I grew up wearing caribou pants, mittens, caribou skin mattress, blankets.
Some people had boots that were made with wolf leggings, sealskin sole bottoms. Baleen was shaved to make insoles. They kept us quite dry and warm as well. But the caribou skin clothing was the best. We would get as many yearlings as we could for our outer clothing. And for a heavy winter, we would get caribou in February or March because the hair was the longest and the skin was the thickest, and we would use those for our winter gear. With that stuff on, you could sleep outside in 50 below and it wouldn't bother you a bit. In the winter, when we were traveling, we didn't build sod houses, we built snow houses. In Canada, they call them igloo, but here in Alaska, we call them apuyak. We'd do a day of travel, and then we'd make an apuyak. The next day, my father would set traps, spend the day there, rest the dogs, give them something to eat, and then the following day, we continue to the next place. We'd go to my dad's sister, who had a house at Dubar. They had a small sod house over there. We didn't have to do anything. We just visit with them, and my dad and his sister were glad to see each other, and they'd talk away whilst kids played outside or go to sleep. By the time we get back to our home, my father would leave us with our aunt or with my grandmother. And then he'd start on his trips and go check his trap line. We were not into 8-to-5 kind of time, you know. We're in a totally different kind. We're in ecological time.
Thank you. siakaroluulo teriganniapulo atqimmatku innaq ugunat pakimnya shonga siksaaruni utingaru. Siakaroluulo teriganniapulo
Thank you.
Teriganiak alang mo kuni magit kisak. Naga tenaytuak ataramik.